स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम अगेन इन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर क्लास. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एक्ट थ्री सीन फाइव. हियर बेलमॉन्ट अ गार्डन एंटर लॉन्सलॉट एंड जेसिका. लॉन्सलॉट सेज हियर, यस ट्रूली फॉर लुक यू द सिंस ऑफ द फादर आर टू बी लेड अपॉन द चिल्ड्रन. Therefore, I promise you, I fear you. I was always plain with you, and so now I speak my agitation of my matter. Therefore, be of good cheer, for truly I think you are damned. He says, yes, it indeed happens. Yes, it indeed happens. The children are punished for the sins of their fathers. Children are punished for the sins of their father. Sins, bad deed of their father. Therefore, I tell you, I am anxious, I am worried about what may happen to you. Your father had done so many bad deeds. So I have always been honest to you. So now I tell you about my great fear on this point. Come on, cheer up, because I think that you are destined to be damned after death. Jessica says, I shall be saved by my husband. He hath made me a Christian. I won't be damned, because my husband's good deed will save me, for he has made me a Christian. I have become a Christian. Lancelot says, truly, the more to blame he. He were Christians, you know, before. Between as many as could we live, well live one by another. This making of Christians will raise the price of ox. If we grow all to the pork eaters, we shall not shortly have a rasher on the coals for money. Lancelot passes here time and says, honestly, then there will be more blame on him, on your husband, because there were enough of us Christians before he converted you. Who could live together? If Christians are increased in this manner, it will raise the price of pigs. This is because of if we all become pork eaters, we will not get at any price a slice of bacon to cook over the coal fire. Jessica says, I'll tell my husband, Lancelot, what you say. Here he comes. I shall tell my husband. I will complain to my husband. I shall tell my husband what you have told me. Lancelot. Here he comes. Lorenzo, the husband of Jessica, has come here in the scene. Enter Lorenzo. Lorenzo says, I shall grow jealous of you shortly, Lancelot, if you thus get my wife into corners. I will be jealous of you, Lancelot, if I find you talking to my wife in quiet places like these. Jessica says, no, you need not fear us, Lorenzo. Lancelot and I are out. He tells me flatly there is no mercy for me in heaven because I am a Jew's daughter, and he says, you are no good member of the commonwealth, for in converting Jews to Christians, you raise the price of pork. Jessica says, no, no. Oh, there is nothing to worry about it, Lorenzo. Lancelot and I had a quarrel. He tells me that there is no mercy for me in heaven, since I am a Jew's daughter. Further, he says that you are not a good member of the Christian community, since by converting Jews to Christianity, you increase the price of pork. Lorenzo says to Launcelot, "Go in, sirrah, bid them prepare for dinner." Launcelot, go and tell them prepare for dinner. Launcelot says, "That is done, sir. I have already told them. They have all stomachs. They are all hungry." Lorenzo says, "Goodly, Lord, what a wit snapper are you? Then bid them prepare dinner." What a comic character you are. Then tell them to prepare dinner. Launcelot says, "That is done too, sir. Only cover is the word." "That has been done. You just need to tell them to lay the table." Lorenzo says, "Will you cover?" "Then, sir, will you order the table to be covered with the dishes, sir?" Launcelot says, "Not so, sir. Neither. I know my duty." Launcelot says, "No, sir, I will not. I am responsible enough not to put on my hat to cover my head in the presence of my superior. When there is superior, I know what I have to do." Lorenzo says, yet more quarreling with occasion, "Wilt thou show the whole wealth of thy wit in an instant? I pray thee understand a plain man in his plain meaning. Go to thy fellows, bid them cover the table, serve in the meat, and we will come in to dinner." Lorenzo says, "What? Still more argument on the use of words. Now, are you trying to show me your wisdom all at once? Try to understand a simple man who speaks plain language. Go to your fellow servants, tell them to lay the table and serve the food. We will come in and eat." Launcelot says, "For the table, sir, it shall be served in. For the meat, sir, it shall be covered. For your coming into dinner, sir, why, let it be as humorous and conceits shall govern." Launcelot says, "The table, sir, will be brought in, and the food will be spread. As for your time of coming into dinner, sir, let that be up to your wish." He goes out. And after this video, lecture number 10, you will go through lecture number 11 soon after this video. Thank you so much, students.